In our previous episode, we learned about mirroring. We're going to take it a step further and make it even easier for you to create sketches and models within SolidWorks. So let's get started. Remember, go New, Part, check your options, Document Properties, Units, and as with all these tutorials, I'm going to do inches again, but it's your preference. First, we're going to do our top plane, right click, sketch, and choose the rectangle tool. We're going to do our 6 by 3 inches. And then we're just going to make a feature of 1/2 inch thick. And there we have our box. Now we're going to select this surface, sketch, and I'm going to do it in 3D mode just so you can see you can also do it that way. Make sure it's horizontal. That little yellow box indicates that. Add a circle. Smart dimension, 1 inch, and 1.75. Okay, and then we're gonna go features, extruded cut, and we'll just do through all. So now we have a box with a hole in it. We can go up to mirror within our features. We can select the right plane, which is the one in the middle. And the features to mirror, we're gonna select our circle. And there you have it. As you can see, it was pretty easy. It's just like sketches, but in this case, we did it in features. Let's look at some other tricks we can do to put more holes into this box. So let's add another sketch. And in this case, I'm gonna put a hole in the corner. So we'll go up here, choose our center line. Make sure it's horizontal. And we're gonna make this one 1/4 inch. And we'll make it 0.375 from the edge. And we need one more dimension, which is the distance from this corner, which we'll make the same. Then we'll go features, extrude a cut, through all. This next feature is really handy. It makes drilling lots of holes really easy. So let's see how it's done. We're going to go up to linear pattern. We're going to select the direction. And in this case, we can just select the edge or one of the lines that's going in the direction we want. We're going to make our distance 1/2 inch. And you can see we already have a new hole coming up. And we'll select, see if 8, we'll try 10. And let's try 12. 12's too many, 11. Now, interestingly enough, for some reason when you do linear patterns, it also counts the first hole that you've drilled or the other feature that you're trying to pattern. So remember, you always add 1. If you need 8 total holes, that's the number you use, even though you're duplicating that one hole 7 times. It takes a little bit to get used to, but it's no big deal. So in this case, we have 11 holes. And as you can see, it quickly drew the holes through the box. Another thing we could do is we can linear pattern in the other direction. So this time we can choose this direction. And you can see we have lots of holes going in the other direction. So let's take it down to try somewhere around 5. I think that's perfect. Some of these holes are going to go through our other holes, but just to show you that how easy it is to do, it's kind of a neat part. Now we could clean it up. If this is what we were going for, we could always go back and I'll show you a new trick. We can simply go into the tree, right click on cut extrude, and then hit suppress. And now you can see we have what would be known as a cheese plate. You can see our one edge has a little extra room, but we can adjust that. Let's see how it's done. First, what we want to do is we want to measure. Hit the measuring tool under evaluate. And you can see we have a distance of 375. And we'll check this one. And we have a distance of 625. So that's basically a distance of a quarter of an inch off that we have. So we can go into our original sketch, right click, and we're going to take a quarter inch off on each side. Remember, we can use math, so minus 0.125, or rather, I'm sorry, minus 250, and then hit OK, minus 1/4. And exit sketch. And now you can see our distance is perfect. So that lesson was pretty easy, but these are really handy tricks that you can use to make sketching and your features much easier to do. I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and don't forget to subscribe to Invention Therapy.